I was introduced to them through a friend who'd been to an auction with them. He said, you've just got to come along and meet these people. They're special, very special.
The Page family were the perfect subject, but they were also the impossible subject.
The father, Mr. Page, had worked in aircraft engineering at one point. He was locally known as Oily Page. When Mr. Page talks about townsfolk, he talks about people that haven't got time. All they do is walk down the street, they come to work, buy a newspaper, sit in the office, and only go home at night.
We didn't use any lights at all throughout the movie. We were improvising crane shots with tractors and all sorts of things. I was very concerned with this idea, actually, about the camera becoming part of the furniture. In the case of The Moon and the Sledgehammer, this did not happen, because obviously with Oily Page, the fact that we was being filmed was the most important thing in the wood that day.
What happened to the people? Did you stay in touch with them?
I was going to ask about the invisible mother.
I wanted to know what actually was going on between the family members.
Did the girls ever marry? I'm just curious.
Did you ever get to see the film kind of on the big screen in the cinema?
When you enter the film, you're off on a journey. You don't know where you're going with this film.
It's put together like a poem, largely instinctively, I think.
It's one of those desert island disc moments where if I could have a luxury, I would take this film with me and a 16mm projector.
I never worked on another documentary like it. That was the end, because for me, it was perfect.
It feels like a film from the future, actually.
It was made at the end of the coal age, you could say, and now as we approach the end of the oil age, perhaps the time has come for this sort of film.
This is extraordinary stuff. This is stuff you would never dare invent. It's the whole point of documentary, the stuff you would not dare invent.